गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई वेलकम यू ऑल इन डिजिटल क्लास ऑफ बायोलॉजी. डियर स्टूडेंट्स, एज यू ऑल नो दैट वी आर स्टडिंग चैप्टर प्लांट किंगडम एंड टुडे आई वुड लाइक टू प्रोसीड विद ब्रायोफाइट्स. आई होप सो दैट यू ऑल आर रेडी. बट बिफोर दैट आई वुड लाइक टू मोटिवेट यू ऑल विद द ब्यूटिफुल सेइंग्स ऑफ लॉर्ड कृष्णा. स्टूडेंट, श्री कृष्ण जी कहते हैं, जीवन ना तो भविष्य में है और ना ही अतीत में. जीवन तो केवल इस पल में है, अर्थात इस पल का अनुभव ही जीवन है. सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, लिव इन प्रेजेंट, वर्क इन योर प्रेजेंट सो दैट योर फ्यूचर कैन बी ब्राइट. ओके, डोंट एवर थिंक ऑफ योर पास्ट. यू कैन जस्ट लर्न द लेसन फ्रॉम योर पास्ट, बट यू हैव टू वर्क इन योर प्रेजेंट ओनली. यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड even the importance of second in your life, okay, then only you will be a successful person in future. Okay, so I hope so that you have understood the deep meaning behind this beautiful thought said by Lord Krishna. So with this I would like to proceed. Student, I have already told you that in the year 1969 R.H. Whitaker gave five kingdom of classification, that is Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae and Animalia. Okay, and now we are starting with the Plantae kingdom, and in Plantae also we had already studied about Thallophyta, and now we will study about Bryophyta. Student, I hope so that this flowchart is clear to you all. We had already studied about Thallophyta, in which we had studied about algae and its different classes. Okay, now we will study about Bryophyta. So student, bryophytes, okay, we all know that it is known as the amphibian of the plant kingdom because, okay, they live in soil but are dependent on water for sexual reproduction. Bryophytes, it include mosses as well as liverworts, okay, and they mostly grow in moist shaded areas in the hills. If I talk about its structure, students, unlike algae, the structure of bryophyte is quite complex, okay, because now it contain root like stem like leaf like structure, okay, and the main plant body of the bryophyte is haploid. Haploid means what? It contains single set of chromosome. For example, in case of human beings there are 46 chromosome, okay, that is 23 pair are there, so we are diploid organism. But in case of your bryophytes, they don't have double set, okay, they have single set, means they have only one set of chromosome. I'll talk about their sex organ. Okay, a sex organ in bryophytes, they are multicellular, they are anthridium in case of male and archegonium in case of female. Okay, and anthridium, they produce anthriozoites which are biflagellated and thus they move, and archegonium, they produce single egg. Next, if I'll talk about fertilization and development, student, what is fertilization? We all know that the fusion of male and female gamete is known as fertilization. Okay, so exactly what happened? The anthrozoites, okay, they will release into the water, and during that moment they will come in contact with the archegonium. As soon as they will come in contact with archegonium, it contain egg, so with that it will fuse with it and it will produce zygote. Clear? In this case, student, zygote do not undergo reduction division immediately, okay, in spite it will produce sporophyte. Okay, and these sporophytes are not free living, but they attached, okay, to the gametophyte which are photosynthetic. Okay, and if gametophyte are photosynthetic, it means they will prepare their food, so from here your sporophytes will take nourishment from it. Okay, and then some cells of sporophyte, they will undergo reduction division, that is meiosis. Okay, and finally it will produce haploid spores. Okay, we know, students, that in case of meiosis, chromosome number, it become half. Okay, suppose if it is 46, it will become 23, and these spores, they germinate finally to produce gametophytes. Student, if I'll talk about the economic importance of these bryophytes, okay, students, some mosses, okay, they act as a food for various herbaceous mammals, birds and other animals. If I'll talk about the species of sphagnum, a moss, okay, they provide peat, and they have long been used as a fuel. Why? Because of their capacity to hold water as packing material for transshipment of living material. Also, mosses along with lichen are the first organism to colonize rocks and hence are of great ecological importance. Okay, then they decompose rocks, making the substrate suitable for the growth of the higher plant. And lastly, they also form dense mat on the soil, and which reduces the impact of falling rain and prevent soil erosion. Okay, student, I have told you that the bryophytes, they are divided into liverworts and mosses. Okay, so what are these liverworts? Here the plant body is thalloid. Thalloid means what? It is not at all differentiated into root, stem and leaf. Okay, so somewhat it is like algae only. The thallus is dorsoventral and closely appressed to the substrate. Okay, means it have upper portion also dorsal and ventral means lower portion also, and it is attached to the substrate means soil. The leafy members have tiny leaf like appendages in two rows on the stem like structure. Okay, they have leaf like and they have stem like structure. If I talk about asexual reproduction, it reproduces by fragmentation. What is fragmentation? One part of the parent will break down and it will grow into a new organism. Okay, and they form gamete. Okay, these gamete have the ability to produce the whole organism. Now, what are these gamete? Gamete are green multicellular asexual buds. Okay, which dwells in small receptacle called gamete cups located on the thalli. As soon as student, I am using the word asexual means they have the ability to grow into a whole organism by their own way. Okay, and then finally what happens? These gamete, they will detach from the parent body and germinate to form new individual, as we have seen in case of hydra. Okay, there also what happened? But it will detach itself and it will grow into a new hydra. Clear? Whereas if I talk about sexual reproduction, okay, male and female sex organ, they are produced. It can be produced on the same thallus or it can be produced on the different thallus also. Okay, so there are different type of liverworts. Okay, some of them they undergo asexual reproduction and some of them they undergo sexual reproduction. Okay, the sporophyte is having capsule like structure. And what happened after meiosis? What is meiosis, student? Meiosis is a kind of division where the progeny contain half number of chromosome. Okay, and what happened after meiosis? Spores, they are produced within the capsule. Okay, capsule is simply the bag like structure inside which spores they form. Okay, and then they disperse with the help of elaters. Okay, we had heard about the term pollination in case of angiosperm, but here there is no, it is also kind of pollination only, means here your spores will, they will disperse, okay, and they will fall anywhere, and wherever they will got the suitable condition, they will germinate to form a free living gametophyte. Okay, in case of pollination, we know that there is the transfer of pollen grain from anther to stigma, but here it is not from anther to stigma, here it is from a capsule. Okay, and with the help of elaters, it will move here and there, and wherever they will get the suitable condition, there it will grow to form a gametophyte. Example are Rickettsia and Markensia. Student, this is, okay, this is your Markensia, and Rickettsia also look like this only. Here you can see gamete cups are there, okay, then rhizoids are there, then archegoniophore is there, and anthridiophore. Okay, archegonium, it is male sex organ, and anthridiophore, it is female sex organ. Okay, so I hope so that you are getting the things. Next, it is student mosses. What happened in mosses? Okay, it is an example of your bryophytes. The predominant stage of the life cycle of a moss is the gametophyte, and this gametophyte consists of two stages. One is your protonema stage and second is your leafy stage. What happened in your protonema stage? It developed to form spores. Okay, it is a creeping, green branched and frequently filamentous stage. And in case of your second stage, what happened? It will develop into secondary protonema as a lateral bud, and it has upright slender axes which bear leaves. Okay, they are attached to the soil through rhizoids, and these rhizoids are multicellular and branched, and this stage it bear sex organ also. And whereas if I talk about vegetative reproduction, it is through fragmentation and budding in your secondary protonema which is developed from the leafy stage. Remember this for your competitive point of view. Next is student sexual reproduction. Here by the sex organs such as antheridia in case of male and archegonades in case of female. Okay, these are produced at the apex, at the tip of the leafy shoots. And after fertilization, what happens? Zygote will develop into a sporophyte, and this sporophyte consists of foot, cyta and capsule. Okay, and we know that the capsule contains spores, and which are formed after meiosis. Okay, what are these meiosis? The meiosis have teeth-like structure and elaborate mechanism of spore dispersal. Example is Funaria and Sphagnum. Student, as you can see in this picture, okay, these are meiosis. Clear? First one is your Funaria and second one is your Sphagnum. Okay, please see this picture from your book. It will be more clear to you from that. Okay. Dear student, with this I have finished my today's lecture. I hope so that you have understood. But if still there is any query, please feel free to call me. Thank you and have a wonderful day ahead.